Today I'm going to discuss about chemical bonding, and I'm Bivishya, Department of Chemistry, IPGDCW, Nampally. Hybridization is the characteristics of the hybridization is here. In earlier in the valency bond theory, we have seen that the overlapping of the pure atomic orbitals are taking place, and each atomic orbital must have a unpaired electron, right? So here some of the features are got changed, means it is the advanced one of the valency bond theory. Okay, so what is hybridization is the orbitals of almost similar energies, means the hybridization is nothing but the merging of the atomic orbitals, the merging of the atomic orbitals of the same atom. So this is called as a hybridization action. So only means in the same atom only there are the different types of the atoms are there. S orbitals are there, p orbitals are there, 3p orbitals are there, 5d orbitals are there, so like that. So s orbitals directly cannot form the bond with cannot overlap with the d orbitals directly. So the energy is also a very important factor here. So in order to form a bond, means in order to, the orbitals must have a almost similar energies in order to hybridize themselves, and belonging to the same atom or ion undergoes the hybridization. And hybridization takes place only in the orbitals, electrons are not involving in it. But in the valency bond theory, first valency bond theory, the electrons involvement is there. The pure atomic orbitals are undergoing the overlap in order to form a covalent bond. But here in the hybridization, the same atom must have a almost similar energy level orbitals, and the merging of the this pure orbitals will be takes place, and this merging of the pure orbitals are called as a hybridization. The number of hybrid orbitals produced is equal to the number of pure orbitals mixed during the hybridization. The number of hybrid orbitals produced is equal to the number of pure orbitals, means how many number of the orbitals are included, means involved in the hybridization process, the same number of the hybridized orbitals also produced. Both half-filled orbitals or fully filled orbitals of equivalent energy can involve in the hybridization. Hybrid orbitals form only sigma bonds, not a pi bond. Orbitals involved in the pi bond formation do not participate in the hybridization. Hybridization never takes place in an isolated atom, but it occurs only at the time of bond formation. So when we take the pure atom, the hybridization never takes place. So when this atom is combined with the another atom of the same element or different element in the time of the bond formation, the pure atomic orbitals are converted into the hybridized orbitals. And the eighth point is the hybrid orbitals are distributed in space as apart as possible, resulting in a definite geometry of the molecule. So they also explain, means this valency bond theory with the help of the hybridized orbitals, means hybridization, after hybridization. So it can also explain about the geometry of the molecules. Geometry is nothing but it is associated with the structural property. And what is the exact structure of the molecule also can be explained by the valency bond theory. Hybridized orbitals provide efficient overlapping than overlapping by the pure s, p and d orbitals. So s and sp, pure atomic orbitals overlapping is actually a partial overlapping. It is having some problems also, but hybridized orbitals provide the efficient overlapping. And hybridized orbitals possess lower energy than the unhybridized orbitals. Unhybridized or pure orbitals. So this hybridized orbitals reaches the lower energy. Always you remember, the energy is decreases, the stability will be increases. The strength of the atom will be increases, or strength of the molecule will be increases, the strength of the bond will be increases. That is all about the hybridization. Now, so depending on the nature and number of the atomic orbitals, the hybridizations have been classified into different types as sp orbital, sp2 hybridized orbitals, sp3 hybridization, sp3 d hybridization, sp3 d2 hybridization, sp3 d3 hybridization. So here the nature is representing that this is the s orbital and this is the p orbital. Sp orbital is the combination of one s and one p orbital here. So here how many pure orbitals are involving? One s orbital, one p orbital. These are the two different nature orbitals, and two orbitals are involving. The number is two here. And similar way, the sp hybridized orbital is forming here. And 1s and 2p orbital, two different orbitals again. One is the s orbital and 2p orbital. The 2p orbitals are having almost same nature. And this totally how many number of the atomic orbitals are involving? Three, right? So three atomic orbitals are involving here. So 1s and 2p orbitals, totally three atomic orbitals. So three hybridized orbitals will be formed. So the name of this is 1s 2p is called as the sp2 hybridization. And similarly, sp3 hybridization, 1s orbital and 3p orbital, total four orbitals is forming. And the name of this hybridization is called as the sp3 hybridization. And if five orbitals are involving, that means 1s 2p 3p orbitals and 1d orbital, so involving here, so this is called as a sp3d hybridization. And here this is a six orbitals are involving, 1s 3p orbitals and 2d orbitals, this is called as a sp3d2 hybridization. And this here, the seven atomic orbitals are involving sp3d3 hybridization. So first one is the sp hybridization, and in sp hybridization, the example I have taken here is beryllium chloride, BeCl2. And in the beryllium chloride, the first one we have to consider this electropositive atom here. So beryllium I am taking. The electronic configuration of beryllium is, so electronic configuration, how can we know the electronic configuration? With the help of the atomic number. So electronic configuration is from the atomic number we can conclude. So what is the atomic number of beryllium? It, which is next to the lithium, right? So hydrogen, helium, hydrogen, for hydrogen it is the atomic number 1, helium 2, lithium 3, and beryllium is 4. So the atomic number of beryllium is 4, which belongs to the alkali earth elements, and which is having a 1s2 2s2. Okay, this belongs to a s block and alkaline earth elements. So this is the first element of the alkaline earth elements group. So 2s2. So here in 1s2 it is a inner orbital, and the second orbital is the valency orbital. So since we are discussing about the valency bond theory now, right? So beryllium is having a paired electrons like this, and this is a lower energy level, lower energy level. But here the 2p second orbital is also having a p orbitals also, but the p orbitals are the empty orbitals. But here in the second orbital there are the paired electrons are there, and all the p orbitals are the empty orbitals. So what it will do is, one of this electron will be jumped into the higher energy of the p orbital. within the same atom only. So here we are taking the beryllium only. So this is the second, means 2s orbital. This is a lower energy than the 2p, lower energy than the 2p. One of the electron is jumping into the, exciting into the empty orbital of the 2p. So here total 3p orbitals are there, right? So 3 2p orbitals are there. So when they merge, means when they merge with each other, the merging is taking place because of the excitation of this electron to the one of the p orbital. So the combination of s and p orbitals are taking place. So here s and p orbitals are taking place and forming the sp hybridized orbitals. And how many s orbital and how many p orbitals are involving? 2 orbitals. So equivalent to this number, the same number of the hybridized orbitals are emerging here. So in this 2sp orbitals, the electron will be means one electron will be there. And now this, because of the presence of this unpaired electron, this they can form a beryllium, can form a two bonds with the this each chlorine atom. So here the beryllium, which forms a bent shape, actually beryllium chloride, in this manner it will form, sorry, it is a linear shape, beryllium chloride, beryllium chloride. So it is a linear form, linear shaped molecule will be formed. And these are the atomic orbitals, actually how they will involve, means the shapes of, with the shapes of the atomic orbital. This is the s orbital of the beryllium and this is the one of the p orbital, means px orbital. Normally we will take a px orbital because it is the horizontal overlapping will be takes place, and when they combine with each other, this hybridized orbitals will be formed. The hybridized orbitals will be formed, and the remaining two is as like only, means they will not changes. They will not change their orientation. They will not change their shape or anything. So beryllium dichloride, the final structure of the beryllium dichloride is this structure. Similar way, we can also explain the bond formation between the, means formation of the alkynes, beryllium dihalides, any halide we can take, and beryllium dihydride, and hydrogen cyanide, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. The next one is the sp2 hybridization. And sp2 hybridization, BF3 molecule we have taken here. And in order to form a three bonds, boron must have a three unpaired electrons. So for that, what it is doing again, it is having the, boron is having a electronic configuration, means atomic number 5. The atomic number of the boron is 5. The electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, right? 2p1. And the two electrons are paired, and this is the lower energy level, and one is a p orbital is having a one electron. But here only one unpaired electron is there. Here paired electrons are there. One pair of the electron is there. So one of the electron will be excited into the s orbital to the p shell, so that the s, p and another p or also gets the unpaired electron, so that the hybridization will be takes place between the 1s and 2p orbitals. So three hybridized orbitals formation will be takes place, and these orbitals are called as the hybridized orbitals, three hybridized orbitals, and each orbital is called as the sp2 hybridization, sp2 hybridized orbitals, sp2 hybridized orbitals. And the structure of boron trifluoride is, it is a triangular structure, triangular structure, bond angle is 120 degrees angle. So the other examples of this sp2 hybridization is alkenes, benzenes, boron halides, aluminium trichloride, and sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, graphite, nitronium ion, carbon ion, anion, etc. And sp3 hybridization, methane, as we discussed already about the methane, and here methane is also carbon, belongs to the p block element, and which is having a electronic configuration of carbon is 1s2 2s2 2p2, right? 2p2. So these two electrons are paired electrons, and in the p orbital there are the unpaired electrons are there, but it has to form a four bonds. It requires four unpaired electrons to form a four bonds with the hydrogen. So it undergoes the hybridization and forms the equivalent four equivalent hybridized orbitals. And if you see the energy level difference between the pure atomic orbitals of the p orbitals of the carbon and sp3 hybridized orbitals of the carbon, so the energy of sp3 hybridized orbitals is lesser than the pure atomic orbitals. And now it got the four electrons, and these four electrons, the hydrogen, four hydrogens are share their electrons with the four unpaired electrons of the carbon, and they forms the tetrahedral structure in this way, and the bond angle will be 109 degree 28 minute. And in this way the orbital orientation will be takes place, means the hybridized orbital, they will combine. When these combine with each other, they forms the sp3 hybridized orbitals, and sp3 hybridized orbitals, when they combine completely, means the structure will become the tetrahedral structure. The next one is the ammonia molecule, and ammonia is also sp3 hybridization only, sp3 hybridization only. But here the nitrogen is having a three lone pair of electrons, but also it is also involving in the hybridization. So sp3 hybridization, but it is because of presence of this two lone pairs, and this is having a structure, pyramidal structure. This structure of ammonia is a pyramidal structure, not tetrahedral like methane, right? So, and this will be explained by the whisper theory. That is very important theory for the students. And the next one is the in sp3 hybridization only, and this s orbital means valency orbitals are undergoing the complete hybridization and forming a sp3 hybridized orbitals. Even though it is having a two lone pair of electrons, the total sp3 hybridized orbitals, total valency orbitals are undergoing the hybridization process and forming a sp3 hybridization, again equal number. So 1, 2, 3, 4 equal number of hybridized orbitals are forming, and this oxygen is having a two lone pair of electrons. See here 2s2 and 2p2. So because of the two lone pair of electrons in this way, so it is having a sp3 hybridization only, but it is having a bent shape or inverse V shape, but the hybridization is sp3 hybridization only. The next one is the PCl5. So if you see the PCl5 means phosphorus pentachloride, and phosphorus belongs to the nitrogen family. So what is the electronic configuration of the nitrogen? If we know the nitrogen, then we can easily know the group elements, nitrogen family elements. So here nitrogen, what is the nitrogen atomic number of the nitrogen? Here it is 7, right? So 7 is the atomic number of the nitrogen, and so what is the electronic configuration? 1s2 2s2 2p3. Yes, So phosphorus is just next to the nitrogen here. So phosphorus is having a electronic configuration of 3s2p3. So 3s2 3p3, and the remaining means 1s2 2s2 2p6 and 3s2 3p3. So total how many electrons will be there? Is that the 5 plus 17, 16? So the atomic number of phosphorus is 15. So it is 1s2 2s2 2p6 and 3s2 3p5. So this is the 3s orbital and 3p orbital, and here the d orbital is also there, but it is the empty orbital. And here these are the unpaired electron, and we know that this is having a 3 unpaired electrons, and but here it requires 5 electrons, 5 unpaired electrons, and 5 unpaired electrons. These are the paired electron and these are the unpaired electron. So from here, from the s orbital to d orbital, now these orbitals are means the empty orbitals, it will take only the requirement. As per the requirement only they will take the empty orbitals. So it will take the one of the d orbital here, and to that d orbital means after hybridization, after merging of these orbitals, the totally 5 sp3d hybridized orbitals will be formed. And in this sp3d hybridized orbitals, each orbital is having a one electron in each, and forms a bonding with the 5 chlorine atoms, and they will form a, what is the structure of this molecule is, this is the trigonal bipyramidal structure, trigonal bipyramidal structure. So the trigonal bipyramidal structure of phosphorus pentachloride will be formed, and other examples are phosphorus pentachloride, stibium pentachloride, xenon difluoride, chlorine trifluoride. Chlorine trifluoride is actually a T-shaped molecule, and SF4 irregular tetrahedral structure it will form, right? So this is about the sp3d hybridization and sp3d2 hybridization. What is the sp3d2 hybridization, and what is the example for this is the SF6. SF6, and S is the sulfur. Sulfur is next to the oxygen actually. Oxygen is having an atomic number of 8, right? So atomic number of 8, and the what is the means after 15 it is a 16, right? So sulfur is having a atomic number 16 now. So oxygen is having the atomic number of 8, 1s2 2s2 p4, so which is having a 3s2 p4, 6, 10, 16. Okay, so atomic number of the sulfur is 16, and the outermost orbital configuration is 3s2 3p4, and here the total 6 electrons are there. Total 6 electrons are there, and sulfur is forming the 6 bonds with the 6 fluorine atoms. In this way, the structure, the final structure of the sulfur hexafluoride is this one octahedral structure it will give. So but here if we see the electronic configuration, the 3s2 atomic orbital is having a paired electrons, and 3p, one of the 3p orbital is also paired electron, only it is having 2 unpaired electrons only. So what it will do, it will take up a one of the d orbital, empty d orbitals here, means 2 d orbitals here, and the merging of this 1s 3p orbitals and 2d orbitals will be takes place, and which will results the 6sp3d2 hybridized orbitals, and they will rearrange these electrons into the all the 6sp3d2 hybridized orbitals will get the 1-1 electron in each, and which results the octahedral geometry or octahedral shape. So this is about the sp3d2 hybridization, and other examples for the sp3d2 hybridizations are, you can try selenium hexafluoride, tellurium hexafluoride, iodine pentafluoride, xenon tetrafluoride, etc. And the next one is the sp3d3 hybridization, and only the inert gas element, and that is also only the iodine, xenon is also can form a sp3d3 hybridization if I am not wrong. And here the example I have taken the IF7, and iodine belongs to the halogen family, and we know what is the general configuration of halogens, right? So NS2NP5 is the general electronic configuration of iodine here. So for this, the N is equal to 4, means 5S2, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iron. 5S2, 5P5, right? 5S2, 5P5. So, this is the electronic configuration of iodine here. And iodine is having only one unpaired electron, but how many bonds around the iodine is there here? Total 7 bonds are there. Total 7 bonds it has to form. So, in order to that, the hybridization will be takes place between the 1s orbital, 3p orbitals and 3d orbitals, and they will combine with each other. The merging will be takes place, and the sp3d3 hybridized orbitals will be formed. So how many sp3d3 hybridizations are forming here, means hybridized orbitals are forming? Total 7, as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 hybridized orbitals are forming here, and that is called sp3d3 hybridization. And the structure of this molecule is pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal bipyramidal structure. As we see here in the three-dimensional one, this five bonds are on the same plane, and this one is on above the plane, and this is on the below the plane. So this is the structure of sp3d3 hybridization. And some important examples of are chlorine trifluoride. This chlorine trifluoride is having a T-shaped molecule, and this is important for the examination point of view. So here the chlorine atom is having what is the electronic configuration? Chlorine is having 17. The atomic number of the chlorine is 17. So this is the atomic electronic configuration of the chlorine here. So this is the outermost orbital, means valency shell, valency orbital. Total 7 electrons are there. So they are arranged in the ground state electronic configuration is, this is a 3s2 and 3p5. 3s2. So one electron, and pairing will be takes place. Only one unpaired electron is there, and this is the ground state electronic configuration. After that, means in order to form a 3 bonds with the 3 fluorides, what it will do, because it is having a 3 third orbital. Third orbital is the outermost orbital, and there is the involvement of the 3D orbital is also there. 3D orbital is also involved here, and because of presence of this 3D orbital, but it is the empty orbital, and it will utilize the empty orbitals of 3D, and so this is a 3s2, and d5 subshells are there, and here 3p5, right? So this is the in excited state. Excited state electronic configuration, what happens? So this one of this electron will be excited into the 3d orbital, one of the 3d orbitals, so that this is having a paired electrons, and here one electron is there, here one electron is there, and one of the electron from this orbital is excited into the this 3d orbital. So here one 3d orbital is involving, and 3p orbitals, three orbitals are involving here, and how many electrons are there? Four electrons are there. So 3p orbital is having a four electrons, and it is involved. So the hybridized orbitals will be formed. And what is the hybridization here? One d orbital is involving s orbital and 3p orbital. So totally how what is the hybridization? S, one s orbital, 3p orbitals, and one d orbital. So sp3 d hybridization. So for sp3 d hybridization, what is the structure, geometry of the molecule is already we have seen. The sp3 d hybridization, what are how many orbitals are there here? Five orbitals, means pentagonal structure we expect. But here, pentagonal structure are in some cases, that is a trigonal bipyramidal structure. Trigonal bipyramidal structure, right? So it is a trigonal bipyramidal structure. Trigonal bipyramidal structure we will expect. But here, because of presence of this lone pair of electrons in the hybridized orbitals, so this lone pair of electrons, there will be a lone pair bond pair repulsions will be there, and here bond pair repulsions are also there. Because of that reason, this chlorine trifluoride is forms the, instead of forming a trigonal bipyramidal structure, it is forming a T-shaped molecule. So it is one of the exemption and a very important one. And the next one is the bromine pentafluoride, and bromine pentafluoride is having a structure like this, pyramidal structure. Bromine pentafluoride is having a pyramidal structure. So how it we will see now. And bromine is having a valency orbital 4s2 4p5, means it is the ground state electronic configuration. So 4s orbital, 4s2 electrons, paired electrons, and this is the 4p orbital, 5 electrons are there initially, so 1 electron, and d orbital is the empty orbital. So this is a 4d is the empty orbital. Now here how many electrons we require? 5 electrons we require. That means the here only one electron is there, and one of the electron will jump over to here, and another electron will also jump over to here. This is the ground state electronic configuration, and in the excited state now the resultant electronic configuration, let us see. From the 4p2 4d, the two electrons are exciting. So here the after exciting of the electrons, three electrons left and two electrons are in the 4d. So how many orbitals are involving in the hybridization now? Total 1 2 3 4 5 6. So six orbitals are involving in the hybridization, right? Six orbitals are involving in the hybridization, and among them, this one is the paired electron. So if the six orbitals are involving, so it should be a octahedral geometry. The geometry will be expected as a octahedral geometry. But here, because of presence of the one lone pair of electron is there on the bromine. So because of this reason, it is having a square pyramidal shape. Square pyramidal shape. And nickel tetracarbonyl. So nickel tetracarbonyl is also one of the very important application for the students, and which is having actually a sp3 hybridization. Sp3 hybridization. And in the sp3 hybridization, which is having a 3d8 4s2. This is the outermost orbital because nickel is belongs to the d block element. So d block. So 3d8 4s2 is the electronic configuration. Since the carbonyl is having a means it is a molecule, neutral molecule. So nickel is in the zero oxidation state only. The nickel does not having any oxidation state here, so it won't lose any electrons in order to form a bonds with the four bonds with the four coordinate covalent bonds with the four carbonyl groups here. So because of that reason, what is happening here, we have to means 3d8 4s2 electronic configuration we are taking, and in this 3d8 4s2 electronic configuration, 4s2 electronic configuration. So the general electronic configuration is 3d8 4s2 1 2 3 4 5. This is the 3d8 4s2. Okay, two electrons are there, and here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So two unpaired electrons are there, but it require how many electrons? Four bonds it required. So when the four means a 4s orbital is involving, means the 4p orbital is also there, right? 4p orbital is also there. Sorry, it is not like this. Yeah, sp3 hybridization. SSS, sorry. This one. Okay, 4p orbital is also involving here. And in this state, what is happening here, that actually these two electrons will, means in the stable electronic configuration, it is having a 3d10 electronic configuration because it is only short of two electrons only. So if it gets that these two electrons also, it will be having a 3d10 electronic configuration, so that it will become a zero electronic configuration. Now all the s orbital means a 4s orbital and 4p orbitals are the empty orbitals only now. So to this empty orbitals of the nickel, to this empty orbitals of the nickel, this carbonyl is acts as the ligand. And what is the ligand? Ligand will donate a pair of electrons to the central metal cation. So because of that reason, I will rub this one also. So in the excited state, so now the s and p orbitals will become a, this empty orbitals will become a each sp3 hybridized orbitals, sp3 hybridized orbitals, sp3 hybridized, four sp3 hybridized orbitals. 4sp3 hybridized orbitals. And to this 4sp3 hybridized orbitals, the carbonyl groups will donate the pair of electrons to the sp3 hybridized orbitals. So in this way, the bond will be formed. So because of this sp3 hybridization, and this is having a tetrahedral shape. Nickel tetracarbonyl is having a tetrahedral shape. And the last but not least one is the xenon difluoride. And the xenon difluoride is having a sp3 dehybridization. And because of the 3 lone pair of electrons, which is actually a linear shape, actually a trigonal bipyramidal shape it must be, but because of the 3 lone pair of electrons, it is having a linear shape. Okay, so by this I'm stopping my lesson.